Dr. Bredesen. Dr. Bredesen is internationally recognized as a neurodegenerative disease expert. His research is changing the approach to the prevention, diagnosis, and management of Alzheimer's. He earned his medical degree from Duke University and went on to serve as chief resident in neurology at the University of California, San Francisco. He has held faculty positions at three University of California schools and directed the program on aging at the Burnham Institute.
Alzheimer's is really a protective response. It's just that all the drug companies are trying to get rid of the amyloid. We want to know why you had the amyloid. That's what we want to get rid of, not just get rid. Great to get rid of the amyloid after you get rid of the thing that's causing the amyloid.
The idea is, what are the things that you're already doing that are in fact contributing to your cognitive decline or to your future cognitive decline? And so we go through a whole day, what would you do? And in fact, you're absolutely right. Food is a critical, critical contributor.
If you have chronic inflammation, there is a reason for it. Either you're, you know, eating something wrong or you're exposed to some pathogen, but there's a reason.
If you have chronic inflammation, as an example, and you can get that because you have a leaky gut or because you're eating the wrong kinds of food with trans fats and things. You mentioned the gut-brain axis a minute ago. This is, as you know, a huge, huge issue. And many people who have the chronic inflammation associated with Alzheimer's do in fact have leaky gut. Very important thing to find out. Very important thing to address. So this is absolutely a contributor.
You mentioned a leaky gut. I've just been having the fortune to do an interview with Dr. Stephen Gundry about the plant paradox and the issue of lectins, which of course may according to him, contribute substantially to leaky gut. And once something has gotten into your bloodstream, then it is a matter of how long it takes for it to get into the brain, isn't it?
Well, of course, there is a blood-brain barrier as well, but not only can you have a leaky gut, you can have a leaky blood-brain barrier, as you know. So yes, these things are all critical players.
Nothing about gut health. Does this person have leaky gut, non-leaky gut? Is the person gluten-sensitive, not gluten-sensitive? Nothing.
Of course, gut is another one. I mean, obviously, you've written about
that
sort
of thing. How does the gut play a role in the brain dementia?
The gut is playing a huge role, and we see a number of these people have very clearly leaky guts, mm-hmm. you know, LPS, mm-hmm. antibodies. Mm-hmm. They've got HSCRPs, and some of them, interestingly, not all. Mm-hmm. They've often got sensitization to gluten, mm-hmm. Some to other grains and things mm-hmm. like that.
Yeah.
So, again, we try to get them on more of a fat diet, just the sort of things that you've recommended over the years.
Some of these issues with grains, especially the unsprouted grains.
Yeah, it's a great point. And in fact, you know, again, when someone comes in with cognitive decline or when you're trying to prevent it, it is critical. If you do not treat cognitive decline successfully, as you know, it's a terminal illness. So this is a very, very serious matter. People are going to die if you don't pull out all the stops. So we argue that, you know, this is an emergency. You want to do everything. You can always reintroduce things later, but you want to get rid of the gluten. You want to get rid of the dairy. And we recommend also to get rid of the grains. In Keto Flex 12.3, we try to stay away from these. Number three is looking at when you eat. So the common thing is we all get under stress. And so what do? We go to the refrigerator at 11 at night, start having some food. Maybe we get a cupcake. Of course, we end up with gluten, which unfortunately for most of us is damaging to our diet. Start poking holes there.